Hello students, today we are going to start with lesson number 2 of history, early Vedic civilization. So Aryans, they belong to Central Asia. They came from Central Asia from the way of Caspian Sea towards Asia and Europe. So some Aryans moved towards Asia, especially towards India, and some towards the other Europe. So in India, the Aryans lived in Sapt Sindhu region for a long time. So this region was comprised of the five rivers of Punjab. So as Punjab is known as Punjab just because of five rivers. So those rivers were Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias and Satluj. And river Indus and the river Saraswati. So they firstly settled at this particular place, and this was the first permanent home of the Aryans. So if question is which region is the permanent home of Aryans, that is known as Sapt Sindhu. And it was here that the hymns of Rigveda were composed. So first Veda that was composed by the Aryans, that was during the early Vedic time period, and area was Sapt Sindhu. Now the sources, how we can say about the Aryans. So we are having some kind of sources to reconstruct the history of Aryan civilization or Vedic civilization. So first and the most important is Rig Veda that was composed during this particular time period, and things are mentioned in this Rig Veda about the goddess which they used to worship, and the type of worship, everything. Okay, so this Rig Veda is the oldest Veda also, and it consists 1028 hymns that are divided into 10 mandalas or books. And it pertains to the period from 1500 BC to 1000 BC. So this was the time period of this Rig Veda. It means it took many years to complete this Veda. Now the next question is, how do Rig Vedic hymns enable us to reconstruct early Vedic history? As we told you that first and the most important source to reconstruct this history is the Rig Veda. So how we can reconstruct the history? First, the things that are mentioned in this Veda, and with the help of those things we can say many things about this civilization. So first, what is mentioned there? Indra is the most favorite god of Rig Vedic Aryans. He is considered to be rain god. So first we got about the god, that Indra was most favorite god, and it was considered as rain god because this civilization was agrarian civilization. So agriculture was the main economic activity, and for agriculture rain was having most, even till the time, even rain is having many very important place in the agricultural type of activity. So they worship Indra. Then the god Indra is also called Purandhar, which means the breaker of forts, and the Aryans often invoked his help to destroy their enemies also. It means first they worship him for the sake of rain, second to destroy their enemies also. Then next, an importance of Indra came Agni. So second important gods that they used to worship was Agni, and Agni was the personification of sacrificial fire. During the yajnas or other sacrifices, Agni was having very important place in the Vedic religion. And Agni was thought of a messenger or a bearer of offering. So if, for example, if they want to give something to a god, then with the help of Agni, they can offer, or they will offer like milk, grain, ghee into that sacrificial fire, and they believed that their message or their offerings definitely will reach to their God. And there are so many references to cow and the bull also in this Rigveda. So Rigvedic hymns are having the reference of cow and bull. It means cow was having most important place in their society, and bull also. And cow was the most important form of wealth during the Rigvedic time period. And the hymn in Rigveda refers to four orders of society. So another thing that we got from this Rigveda, their society. So their society was having four sections. The priests, that are known as Brahmins, the warriors, means Kshatriyas, common people that engaged in agriculture, trade or other industrial works, they were known as Vaishyas, and the servants, the workers, were known as the Shudras. It means society was divided into four sections. How we can say? With the help of Rigvedic hymns. So, this Rigveda is very important to reconstruct their history or the early Vedic civilization. Then, early Vedic time period was non-iron using phase. How? Because there is no reference of iron in the Vedas. Then is the early Vedic society. Whenever we are talking about our society, it means we are talking about our families, position of men's, women's, or type of agriculture that they use, maybe agriculture or other activities to survive. So first was the family. It was the basic unit of the social structure. And the joint family system was there at that time. And the houses they used to build of wood or reed. Reed means a kind of grasses. And the Rigvedic society was patriarchal. Patriarchal means the master of the house will be the eldest male member and dominate the family also. Then is the position of women. During the early time period, women were treated as being equal with men. It means no discrimination was there between men or women. Even they can took part in all religious rites. Women were given education. Even women scholars were there. And girls were having the freedom to choose their husbands. Monogamy was in practice, means one man will be married with the one woman. But in some we are having examples of polygamy also, where one male person used to marry with the more than one girl or a female person. And the child marriage, the sati system, and parda, this kind of social evils were not there in the early Vedic time period. Then is the fourfold varna system. Fourfold, like in the beginning we discussed about the society, that society was divided into four sections. So fourfold society, Brahmin, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, and Shudras were there. It means society was divided into these four sections. And persons, those who used to explain the Vedic text, perform the religious ceremonies, they are known as Brahmins. And the persons belonging to ruling class or the warrior person, they were known as Kshatriyas. Common person, usually known as Vaishyas. And those who were the servants of other three classes, they were known as Shudras, and Shudras were not having much to own. Okay, then is the Rigvedic economy. First of all, agriculture. As it was agrarian economy, so agriculture was the main economic activity, or the main occupation was agriculture. Then, in this time period, they mainly grow food crops Then they were having cattle. They pray for good health, good harvesting, and plenty of rain just because of the goodness of their agriculture. Then domestication of animals. So agrarian society was there. It means animals were having very important place in their life. Cattle formed an important item of dan also, means gifts for a kind of like if yajnas were there to be performed, so they used to give gifts to the priests. And the word gomat was used to signify a wealthy person. Meant the one who possessed many cattle, especially the cows and bulls. It means the person who were having more number of cows and bulls. It means that person was the rich one. Other animals were like ox, horse, dog, and goat, and the sheep also. These were the animals domesticated during the early Vedic time. Craft. Men and women were engaged in weaving cloth. It means weaving or cloth weaving was another very important occupation. And both men as well as women both were engaged in this. And the metal work or the smiths were skilled in making weapons, implements, and ornaments. It means metal was discovered. It's okay, not iron. And with the help of other metals, they used to make their weapons, other implements, ornaments, etc. And the metal ayas mentioned in the Rig Veda is generally taken to mean copper or bronze. It means copper or bronze was discovered. Trade and transactions. So the people were engaged in trade, mainly cloth and leather goods. So these were the main items of trade. And the barter system was practiced. So barter system means it means they were not using money mainly to purchase something in return when some other good, some other things are given. That system is known as the barter system. So this barter system was in practice for trade type of purposes. And the cow was the standard unit of value also. It means cow was also used. Then they use horses and bullocks for carrying goods from one place to another place. It means the way of shifting the goods were mainly the horse and bull carts. And they also transported goods through the inland rivers. It means waterway was also in use to transport the goods, to transport the things, mainly for trade purposes. So this was their economy. Now, the governance and the political life. Few villages during that period of time, they formed one Vishya, and that Vishya was ruled or administered by Vishyapati, and many Vishyas formed a Jana, and that Jana was ruled by a Rajan or a king. It means just we are having one country and it's having number of states, and those number of states are having number of districts. Similarly, that was their number of villages formed Vishyas, number of Vishyas formed Janas. Vishyas were ruled by Vishyapati or administered by Vishyapati, and the Janas, or we can say the kingdom, was ruled by one ruler or king. And there were a number of officials also, like Senani, Purohita, and Gramini. So they were there to help the ruler, to help the king in various responsibilities of the government. It means to run the government, to run the administration of their area, ruler was having number of other officials. And in this period existed the two institutions which exercised an effective check on the powers of the king. That were the Samiti. Samiti was formed by the representatives of the people. Who were there in this Samiti? The chiefs or the leaders of villages and the towns. Like we are having Sarpanch when we are talking about the villages, and when we are talking about the towns, like we are having councillors and others. similarly they were having. And next was the Sabha. So Samiti formed by the representatives of the people, and everything, for example, any new action there to be taken by the king, and it will be advised by the persons of the Samiti. And the Sabha, it was consisted of few eminent persons, men of wealth, like wealthy or rich persons, and the learning, educated one. And it was like a council of elders which guided the king in his administrative functions. So these two groups, so one was the Samiti, another one the Sabha, these two powerful institutions were there, those who were there to put a check on the powers of a king. It means king during that time cannot be a dictator. Then early Vedic religion. So when we are talking about the early Vedic religion, their religion was simple. They used to worship the natural objects. So nature worship was there. And the religion of Rigvedic Aryans was very simple, as I told you. And the natural objects, they were attracting the people of that time period. So they started to worship the natural objects like Varuna, that is known as Usha, Vayu. Then Surya, sun god. Indra, the god of thunder and rain and war also. Vayu, wind god. Prithvi, the goddess of earth and Agni personified, like we already discussed this. Na? So though they worship many gods, they believe that all are the manifest.